What do electric cars, precision-guided missiles, and the electronic screen you're watching right now have in common? They all depend on metals with unique properties that are inside almost every piece of technology you can think of. These are called critical minerals, as they are considered essential to the nation's economy and security. Critical minerals we need to import are called strategic minerals. Hello, my name is Steve Masterman. I am the state geologist and director of Alaska's Division of Geological and Geophysical Surveys and a UA graduate. And I'd like to share some information with you about critical minerals, which include the rare earth elements, or REEs, you have probably been hearing about. The rare earth elements are clumped together at the end of the periodic table, atomic numbers 57 through 71, and they have difficult to pronounce Greek or Scandinavian names. Critical minerals consist of a broad array of elements, not just rare earth elements. Critical minerals are used in everyday items like computer hard drives, TV screens, and smartphones, and also in GPS devices and green technologies such as wind turbines. Critical minerals are just as crucial for military applications such as lasers, radar, missile guidance systems, satellites, and aircraft electronics. Although more abundant than the name rare earth might suggest, there are only a few places on Earth with concentrations high enough to mine, and most of the world's supply of these elements comes from only a few countries, and as with many critical minerals, there's no current domestic production. The need for stable supplies of rare earth elements was highlighted a few years ago when their free flow in the global economy was threatened by China suspending their exportation. National security and economic stability require stable supplies of these materials. China has a virtual monopoly on the global mining, refining, and processing of rare earth elements, supplying as much as 97% of the world's supply. And in 2010, China used that power to disrupt the world supply. At a recent Senate hearing on the topic, Alaska's Senator Dan Sullivan expressed his concern about this.
The key issue on this is that we know we're relying on China. In many cases, we, the United States of America, actually have these critical minerals, for example, in the great state of Alaska, and we actually mine them and process them in ways with much, much higher environmental standards than the Chinese. So if that's the case, and mining and processing create good jobs, why wouldn't we do it here as opposed over there?
As Senator Sullivan noted, Alaska's mineral wealth could offer a critical lifeline going forward, and the University of Alaska can help lead the way. Alaska has untapped critical minerals, including rare earth element deposits, that could supply the U.S.'s raw material needs. The federal government recognizes the potential Alaska possesses, and recent work by the USGS and the Alaska Division of Geological and Geophysical Surveys defined numerous mineral belts with potential to host critical mineral deposits. In Southeast Alaska, Canadian company Ucor Rare Earth Metals has identified a rare earth deposit on Prince of Wales Island called Bokan Mountain, which it says is the highest grade heavy rare earth element project in the United States. In 2014, the state legislature authorized the Alaska Industrial Development and Export Agency, or AIDA, to invest up to $145 million to support the development of Ucor's Bokan Mountain project and for building a rare earth element separation facility envisioned in Ketchikan. While Bokan Mountain is the most advanced rare earth deposit in Alaska, there are similarly advanced deposits of other critical minerals in Alaska, such as barite in the Palmer project near Haines and graphite in the Graphite Creek deposit on the Sioux Peninsula. Alaska's mineral endowment makes it an important domestic location to supply these critical minerals. To locate, develop, and produce these and other deposits in Alaska requires improving existing and developing new technologies. And that is where the University of Alaska enters.
The public impact of university research is significant. Specific to these minerals, the University of Alaska is engaged in ways to boost the development of Alaska's mineral industries. This spring, the U.S. Department of Energy awarded the University of Alaska Fairbanks a $1.5 million grant for a research project aimed at reducing reliance on imported critical minerals. In the project, UAF is working with DGGS, Native corporations, and the resource development industries. This project will systematically perform a set of broad assessments in Alaska's resource basins. The acronym CORE-CM is used to describe such basins, and CORE-CM stands for carbon ore, rare earths, and critical minerals. The project will develop a priority matrix for ranking basins based upon CORE-CM content, access to infrastructure, technological readiness to exploit the resource, environmental factors, and the market potential of the resource. This could lead to establishing Alaska's resources as globally competitive sources of supply. The university actively conducts research and training to support industrial applications and to bolster Alaska's economy. Many of those activities surround engineering and workforce development. UA's research in the sciences will also play a big role in the development of Alaska's critical minerals. When she was a UAF faculty member, Provost Anupma Prakash created a hyperspectral imaging laboratory called HiLab, in part to help discover mineral deposits. HiLab uses airborne cameras and ground spectrometers to create a detailed map of an area's geologic makeup by measuring surface reflectivity in a variety of wavelengths. Mining exploration experts can then look at the mineral composition of a surface and deduce what might lie beneath. It has the potential to identify regions that show promise for further mineral exploration in Alaska.
While the minerals are here, one of the issues is how to make it profitable. Mining is just the first step. Extracting rare earth elements and other critical minerals from raw ore is a difficult process. Extracting the individual metals requires a complicated refining process that converts ore into oxides and then converts these oxides into refined metals. That is why the University of Alaska is such an important part of bringing these critical minerals to market. At the University of Alaska Anchorage, Dr. Brandon Briggs, associate professor in the Department of Biological Sciences, is currently pursuing a patent for a biotechnological advance that uses microbes to extract rare earth elements from Alaska resources such as coal.
Alaska could be at the forefront of a new resource industry that could deliver rare earth elements. I'm completing this important work alongside UA chemistry student and research assistant Michael Martinez. We recently founded the company Arctic Biotech Oath to develop and market this particular technology. Michael has recently won the High North Young Entrepreneurs Award for his work with this company. Initial research was conducted by Dr. Ghosh at UAF to determine the rare earth element content in Alaska's coal. This is now a joint project with UAA to allow us to complement each other's expertise. What we're doing now is identifying different bacteria from Alaskan environments that are able to extract these rare earth elements without producing hazardous chemicals. It's more efficient than conventional methods. Conventional mining techniques use strong acids that are inefficient and damaging to the environment. This revolutionary biotechnology could change the field of mining for rare earth elements and critical elements.
The university plays an important role in providing trained researchers and skilled workforce for Alaska's mining industry. Across the three universities, 44 institutional programs have been identified whose graduates play a key role in the state's mining, extraction, and mineral processing workforce. UA researchers play a leading role in pushing technology forward to help support this industry.
The Center for Mine Training at the University of Alaska Southeast and the Mining and Petroleum Training Service at the University of Alaska Fairbanks help put people to work in Alaska's mining industry. Over the past 10 years, more than 2,300 people have graduated from UA programs important to the mining industry. And these graduates earn an average wage of over $104,000 a year within 5 years.
Research done throughout the UA system has positively impacted the economy of the state and our nation. We will continue this effort as part of our mission.
To fully help realize the state's critical mineral potential, the University of Alaska will need federal, state, and UA investments and relationships and partnerships with industry so that barriers to development can be identified and removed. Working together, there is no doubt that there is opportunity for the university and the state to lead the U.S. in providing critical minerals to the world.